Hello everyone! Welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today I will show you the progress that I made in the Tenfold Enchantments by Klara Makova. I try to finish this book someday. It's already taking me years and years of coloring, so there are a lot of my older works in this one. And I'm not coloring every month in it. I think I do a picture each season, and yeah, there will only be call it for like 3, maybe 4 a year, and I'm okay with it. It's a slow process to complete the coloring book, and I'm enjoying the slow way with it. So let's dive in and see what I've colored. There's the bookmark. This is the second book in the Klara Makova serie, and this is the one that I like the most. There are bigger pictures with less little details going on the pages. The way I color it is I'm only tackling the main pictures, not the little side ones, so I'm only coloring those. You can see the pictures are still filled with everything, but there is a little less of the pictures. This one I've colored with my Luminance pencils on top of the Neo Color 2 by Caran d'Ache. And I'm so happy that I've used a limited color palette. It is suiting the page a lot. Yes, it can use more shading, and I'm okay with it. It's an older one. And I didn't use any gesso for the background, so it's very splotchy and also a learning curve. So this was the first one. I don't know if it was the first one that I've colored in the book. I cannot remember. This one I did for Easter this year. I'm very happy with the outcome of it. I'm so in love with the little duck. It's cute. And I've added some of the glitter glue on the beads. It's not really showing up, I think. Oh, there we go. I've used the Prismacolor pencils, Posca paint pen for the background. Not that happy with the background color. I think it's a little bit too vibrant. It's okay. I will leave it this way. It is more a fairy tale-y book, and I'm okay with brighter colors, even that it is not my favorite. This one is fun. And this one. A lot of pictures to color. This is also one of my earlier colorings, also with Luminance pencils. And there was a lot of shimmer on the key, and it lost all its sparkle. I like how I've colored the beads. There are little hints of gel pen, so they are see-through, I think. I can hold it up, maybe. Yeah, I'm happy with those little things that I tried, and I like the color combinations that I've used. The only downside of this page is all the little hairs that I tried to draw in with a gel pen, and yeah, I'm not happy with that. It looked like little worms, and yeah, it's a learning curve. This one I've colored with my Polychromos pencils. There is some gel pen for the hair. I'm not that happy with. You can see there's not that much shading going on. It's a very old one. I've used Amsterdam acrylic paint for the background. There is some jelly roll clay pen, I think, on top of the wings to make them shiny. There's white gel pen on the wings. Also on the ladybugs. Yeah. A very early one. I hope to color this one this year for Mermaid. I'm looking forward to this one. Another one perfect for Mermaid. Maybe next year. This is also colored with polychromos pencils, and I'm still happy with it. It's an easy one, and it took a lot of effort when I was coloring it. But yeah, I was learning my pencils, and it was a fun process. I can look back at it and remember that I had a lot of fun with it. This one I've colored with a Marco Tribute to the Master coloring pencils. Those are so smooth, so soft, wonderful to color in the book. I've colored the background with paint, with a little bit of gesso, and you can see the coverage of the pages so much more solid. I like it. Happy with this page. I like the glow of the jellyfish. Like the limited color palette that I've used. This one is okay. I wish I chose another color for the house, but besides that, I'm okay with it. Also a very early one. This one I've colored last year. Happy with a purple background. And you can see it's just a small, big picture with less things going on. And yeah, I'm enjoying it, coloring pictures like this. I'm happy with the outcome of the little watch. And the fur is okay. Very spring pastel vibe. I'm happy with it. Yes. Nice one. This one is a fun one. Oh, I remember this one. I've colored it with the Derwent Lightfast pencils. When they released the first set of pencils, there were 36 colors only. So it was a very limited color palette. And I based the picture with the Neo colors and went on top with the Lightfast. And they work wonderful together. I'm happy with the light on the picture, reflecting on the mouse, on the berries, and I'm very happy with the class. Yeah, I like it. And then another picture that I've colored with the polychromos pencils, and I'm not that happy with. Yeah, I've used the Tombow paint pens, the markers, for the background. And you can see when you use a gel pen on top, it will fade away. It is not a bright white, and because it's water medium, water based marker. It's a learning curve. This one I'm not that happy with either. It's okay. This one will be perfect for Halloween and make it very creepy looking. Will be fun. This one I have colored with the base of Neo colors. And there is no gesso for the background, so you can really see the streakiness of it. I think I've used the luminance, but it also can be polychromos. Not sure anymore. This one I've colored last year, and there's a video about how I have colored the wood. I'm happy with the wood, not with the background. I like the glowing lanterns, but it's looking okay. I just don't think the color of the background is suiting the picture very well, so yeah, it can happen. I think it was the last one for this one. Yes, it was the last one. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching. And I hope to see you next time. Bye.